Deadly fungal, resistant to medicine. Tonight, growing global concern over a superbug fungus that was treated right here in Oklahoma.
This is an incredibly sticky, tenacious bug.
Those who are the most susceptible, well, are the people who are already the sickest. The bug, hopefully, now gone from our state, but now questions over why we didn't know about it sooner. News 4's Brent Skarke talked to doctors about it today. Brent, what'd you find out?
Well, Kevin, it's a superbug with confirmed cases in 12 different states, most of those in New York and Chicago, but a couple right here in Oklahoma since 2017. The big question, why are we now just finding out about this 2 years later?
Yeast can cause infections in a variety of different body sites.
And that's the fear with Candida auris, a potentially deadly fungus.
If they get a yeast infection, particularly in their bloodstream, it can be fatal.
This particular strain, known as a superbug, because it's resistant to all three types of drugs typically used.
It's not necessarily that the superbugs are more likely to cause disease. It's just that in certain patients, when they do cause disease, they are more difficult to get rid of because we don't have as many weapons to fight them.
Candida auris was first identified in Japan, and while more prevalent overseas, 600-plus cases have been documented in the U.S. Recently, the CDC released information that two of them right here in Oklahoma, one in southeast Oklahoma in 2018, the other at OU Medical Center in Oklahoma City in 2017. Officials from OU and the CDC confirmed the case was identified, isolated, and treated. The work in Oklahoma was deemed successful because CDC did not find further evidence of transmission. But why is this information just now being released to the public?
In both occurrences, there was no risk of further transmission to other patients that were identified.
The Oklahoma Department of Health was involved in both Candida auris cases. They say they helped identify the pathogen and communicated the findings to other health facilities. But as far as releasing information on the superbug to the public, they say it boils down to patient privacy.
But if it seems like it's very limited to an isolated incident of an individual where exposure likely occurred, you know, from a prior exposure at another facility, another location, then that's where the communication to the general public may be limited. We do try to strike a good balance with informing the public of specific risks when they're occurring, but at the same time, protecting individuals' confidentiality when they're involved with public health investigations.
Well, the state health department tells me that medical providers must tell the CDC about a superbug like Candida auris, but as for telling the general public, that is still the state health department's call. Jolene.
Thank you, Brent.